For the first time since the 2019 Whakaari White Island volcanic eruption, families of the overseas victims have come to New Zealand to remember their lost loved ones. Just after 2 p.m. on December the 9th, 3 years ago, the active volcano erupted while tours were in progress. 47 people were on the island, 5 New Zealanders among the overseas visitors. Tourists on the boats nearby could see the plumes and return to the island to help rescue badly burned tourists and guides. The first helicopter pilots arrived about an hour after the eruption. They reported the air being acidic and wading through thick ash. 12 people were airlifted off. 10 subsequently died. 7 pilots have received bravery awards for their extraordinary heroism that day. Of the 47 people on the volcano as it blew, 22 lost their lives. 2 bodies have never been recovered. Many survivors suffering severe injuries and trauma. Multiple organisations face charges over health and safety procedures. All have pleaded not guilty, with the trial set down for next year. Today, the commemorations began with a dawn service, attended by many of the people involved on the day, along with the families of the victims. Yvonne Tahana reports.
In the pre-dawn darkness, Ngāti Awa singing to soothe grief, gathering as they have every year since the 2019 Whakaari eruption. This Memorial Day is special though, a small delegation of Australians making the trip to Whakatane for the occasion. Relatives of Julia and Jessica Richards helped down to the shoreline for their own moment.
Julia and Jess have a love of travel. They lost them doing something that they love.
Julia, a Brisbane mum, was 47. Her daughter was just 20. First responder Tracy Rhodes' memories of that terrible day have lingered. She's never stopped thinking about the teenage boy she treated.
He ended up going off in the rescue helicopter, and that was the last we'd seen of him. All we knew that his name started with J, and he was from Australia.
J stood for Jesse Langford. Tragically, both his mother and father were killed. His sister's body has never been recovered. But a welcome surprise for one of his heroes this morning.
We've just met him and he's absolutely fine. He's very grateful for all of our crew and everyone on that day.
A tribal leader shared comforting words as light drizzle fell.
In Māoridom, that's a tohu of aroha.
It was not the only ceremony. Some families carried pictures of the dead onto Te Manuka Tūtahi Marae, where they were formally welcomed.
Media were not allowed inside the wharenui to listen to speeches, but we could listen to a live stream. One Australian who lost 2 family members thanked Ngāti Awa for looking after her in the days following the eruption. She said they put their whole hearts into doing that.
It's incredibly amazing, the experience that Ngāti Awa has provided to the people here, the hospitality, the counselling, and just the sense of family. So they call everyone that they looked after family, and I think that's really true, and we felt that today in the ceremony.
Still, the tribe's tour company, alongside a raft of others, face health and safety charges.
Looking at what happened and then putting improvements in place is always something that we would welcome.
Today, a moment to look back as the fallout from Whakaari goes on. Yvonne Tahana, One News.